Please write down wavelength. Wavelength, what do you think wavelength is? Okay, good. Please write down. Wavelength is the distance between two consecutive crests or troughs. Along the direction of velocity. In the direction of velocity. Okay. But anyways, if you join two crests, it will be in the direction of velocity only. But wavelength, I'm not sure whether you guys know, you can also find out, so leave it. That is very relevant. Okay, so distance between two consecutive crests or two consecutive troughs is the wavelength. And is represented by a Greek letter. What is this?
Lambda.
It is called lambda. Okay, now listen here. Okay, fine. So, time period is how much? Time period is time taken to two consecutive crests to pass. Wavelength is distance between two consecutive crests. So, if velocity is v, can you tell me relation between time period, wavelength, and velocity of wave? Whatever you discussed based on that, you can tell me. Time taken to travel one wavelength. So one wavelength is a distance. Distance is one wavelength divided by time taken is time period. This should be equal to speed v. So this relation makes sense, right? So this equation is your, I mean, it's the basic one of those basic equation like kinematics equation. It is going to be used in various numericals. You need to get comfortable with this. By the way, 1 by time period is what?
Frequency.
So I can also say lambda into frequency is the velocity. Okay, any doubts till now, anything? Any doubts? What do you think the SI unit of wavelength is? It's a length. Meters. SI unit of time period?
Seconds.
SI unit of frequency?
Hertz.
So what was it? So Hertz was one of the greatest scientists who studied in great detail about the waves, electromagnetic waves as well as mechanical waves. If he would not have been there, we could not imagine the whatever we are using, as satellite televisions and everything else. Okay. So to honor him, we have created a unit Hertz. Otherwise we don't need SI unit of frequency. It will be 1 by second. Just like velocity is meter per second, 1 by time period will be 1 by second. Right? But just to honor him, we are calling 1 by second as Hertz. Fine? Now when we talk about the frequency, Hertz is an extremely low frequency, like 5 Hertz is a very very low frequency. Typically the frequencies will be kilohertz, at least. Kilohertz. Kilo is how much?
1000.
So if I tell you 5 kilowatt, it means 5000 Hertz. There will be megahertz. Mega is 10 is power 6. 5 megahertz is 5 into 10 is power 6 Hertz. So you need to convert it into Hertz because SI unit is Hertz. If I tell you megahertz is the frequency, you need to, when you solve problem, you need to convert it into Hertz and then solve it. Fine? Velocity SI unit is same, meter per second. Okay? So let's solve one or two questions. I have also brought with me a worksheet that I don't know if we have time to do that. Fine, write down. You might have done this in the school also, but the purpose is not to get the answer. Purpose is whatever you have just learned, try using it so that it becomes more clear. Right now, the frequency of a sound wave is 2 kilohertz. Anyways, the sound wave of frequency 2 kilohertz and wavelength 35 centimeters. Okay. What? Okay, chalo. You find out velocity and you need to find out how much time it will take to travel 1.5 km. How much time the wave will take to travel this much? What is the answer? Velocity of the sound is wavelength into frequency. We just learned, right? Wavelength is 35 centimeter. This you have to convert in meters, wavelength, and then frequency is 2 kilohertz. 2 into 10 is power 3. So this is 700 meter per second. So the time taken to travel 1.5 km is, distance is 1500 meters divided by this. So it is 2.1 roughly 2.1 seconds. It's okay, just one single digit is fine. Okay, so we have learned about the frequency, wavelength, and velocity. The last thing is amplitude. Write down amplitude. Right on, amplitude is the maximum amount of maximum amount of displacement. Amplitude is maximum amount of displacement the particle of the medium can have. Maximum amount of displacement the particle of the medium can have. Okay? So if I tell you that this is a wave, where is the amplitude? I have to draw a line on the center. Do I need to draw a line? Why?
So because it vibrates about the position.
Okay. So this is the initial position of all the particles. It was, as we can say, a wire like this. A wire in the initial position. It is no particle vibrating. So whatever happens above this and below this is the vibration. The maximum possible vibration is this much. So this much is the amplitude, capital A, it gets represented by, and the SI unit is meters only. Fine. Now take a string example itself. How can you increase the amplitude of a wave? You make it hard. You put the string up and down harder, right? So by doing this more, what I am trying to do? You're increasing amplitude as well as trying to create more energy as well. So it means that greater the amplitude, greater the energy transmitted by the wave. Please write down. If amplitude is more, the rate of energy transfer, the rate of energy transfer by the wave will be more. It happens automatically. Fine? Rate of energy transfer by the wave will be more. So when you are using wave, you are not worried about how much is the energy of the wave. You are worried about how faster, how quickly I am getting energy from the wave. Fine? So there is a term called power, which you have studied in fact. Power is rate at which you get the energy. Isn't it? Please write it down. Power is, when I say rate of energy transfer, it means power only. Power is rate of energy transfer. That is joule per second. Rate with respect to time, rate at which energy gets transferred is the power.
So, can we say amplitude and power are directly associated?
See, there is a formula that you learn in 11 that intensity is proportional to frequency square and amplitude square. Okay, the velocity of wave also comes in the equation, but we are not getting into all that. Okay, not amplitude, amplitude square. If you double the amplitude, energy becomes 4 times. Okay, but let's not get into that. Power is rate at which energy gets transmitted. Fine. Now let's talk about sun. Sun emits EM wave radiations. It reaches Earth. Okay. Do you care about how much energy per unit time sun emits, or how much energy per unit time Earth gets? How much you get per unit time, that is what matters, right? And of course you don't get entire energy. So energy is distributed. Are you getting it? Energy is distributed when you talk about wave. So power, just knowing power is not enough. Power per unit area you must know. So that I can ask you that if power per unit area is this, how much is the power for 1 meter square area? You are not getting it. Okay, example of sun. So this is sun, it emits radiation. How the radiation get distributed? How do you, I mean, do you know this? It gets distributed in a spherical this thing. Yeah, I mean spherical radial symmetry. So Earth is here. This is Earth. Not even this. If sun is this much, you can't see the Earth. So it is quite big, which I have drawn. Fine. So the rate, if you draw a sphere of this much radius, which is a distance of Earth from the sun, your entire energy by the sun is spread in this radius. Getting it? So let's say sun emits power of P. So power per unit area is power divided by the sphere's surface area. This is the power per unit area in this big sphere, on which the area of the Earth is, let's say, small a. So the power which Earth receives is power per unit area multiplied by the area of the Earth. Got it now? So this, you're not going to get asked question on this. I'm just telling this so that you understand the significance of power per unit area, rather than just knowing power. If I tell you, okay, power emitted by sun is this much, that doesn't mean anything to you. You might be sitting in Pluto, where no, I mean, absolutely very less energy reaches from the sun. So you have no, I mean, the amount of energy emitted by sun has no meaning to you if that energy is not reaching to you. So my concern is power per unit area, which is intensity. Okay, so when we talk about wave, intensity makes lot more sense than just talking about energy or power. Fine. So please write down, intensity is,
so what is a?
Small a. It is a projected area of the Earth. Earth will look like a disk.
Yes, sir. So, but since we are telling if A increases more, we get more power than sun.
But power per unit area on the earth will remain same. You understand what I am trying to say? If earth is this much, it will receive more power. But the power received on small area on the earth will remain that much. In fact, on this entire sphere, power per unit area is same. If you increase the area of earth, total power received will be same, but power per unit area remains the same. The temperature of earth will not go up. But if you go closer, if earth comes here, then power per unit area becomes more. Then temperature of earth remains, become higher.
What?
No? Should I proceed? Okay, please write down intensity of a wave is power per unit area. Intensity of a wave is power per unit area. Okay, and in bracket you write down power is proportional to amplitude square, just for you to know. More is the amplitude, more will be the power delivered. In fact, amplitude square times. If you double the amplitude, power becomes 4 times. Okay? So these are the basic characteristic of this sound. Not only just sound, whatever you have learned about intensity, wavelength, frequency and speed, this is applicable for all kinds of waves, not just sound. Are you getting it? Even though in your textbook it is written characteristic of sound wave, these are the characteristic of any kind of wave. Fine? But then there are few characteristics which are specific to the sound. Only with respect to sound, there are few characteristics.